Can I get your attention for just a second? If you have an empty seat between you, we've got some people still standing, so if everybody could scoot in, if there's some empty seats so that the people that are standing could take their seats, it would be great. Thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. How you doing? My name is Dr. Mark Reed. I'm the Music Department Chairman here at Fort Lewis College. For those of you that have been here before, welcome back. For those of you whose first time on campus, welcome to Fort Lewis College. You're in for a great afternoon of music. We have four ensembles ranging from middle school to three high school ensembles. First is the middle school ensemble, directed by Dr. Walter Cummings. Dr. Cummings has been teaching and publishing music for several decades, began his career in Mississippi, he's kind of moved all over the country and settled in Grand Junction, just a short drive north of here, runs a ever-burgeoning publishing company known as Grand Mesa Music Publishing. He also does a little bit of composing and has been working with the middle school, which I'll tell you a bunch more about that. But without further ado, here is Dr. Walter Cummings and the middle school band.
I won't talk too much, but I want to tell you I've had a blast working with your children. this weekend. They have been the most amazing group of middle school kids I've ever had the privilege to be around. They've been phenomenal. I am very, very proud of them. There's an O Crosby, Stills, and Nash song. You probably know it. Teach your children well. You guys have done it. These kids are so respectful, and they've tried so hard for me. We've had a wonderful time, and I believe it's going to reflect in the music. We'll start off with a little march called Rudimentary March. Now we're going to slow things down a bit, and we're going to play the one piece. They asked me to conduct this primarily because I'm a composer. So here's my composition for this program. This was inspired by a late evening walk I took in Grand Junction. One of my favorite places to walk was when I was living in downtown Grand Junction on the Lincoln Park Golf Course, if you've been there. It's dangerous to go out during the day, but late in the evening when the golfers have gone away, I was taking a really nice stroll. I wasn't expecting this, but the moon started rising in the east over Grand Mesa. And finally, the whole thing is showing its face is orange. You know how big it can look when it's right on the horizon. So, and I thought, wow, what a nice moment. I wonder if I can capture that in music. And all of a sudden, this little tune popped in my head and went right home and started on the piece. It was done in about 2 or 3 days. And it's still one of the most successful pieces written in 1998. It's still around in the middle school band literature, gets lots of play, and I think it's very pretty, and these guys have done a fabulous job on it. This is called Song for the Winter Moon. So I get to double my fun as composer and conductor and get to conduct my own piece. It's been a thrill, absolute thrill. So thank you guys. You made this composer very happy. Sweet work on that. All righty. So as a composer, as a publisher, one of the things I do, very much like a book publisher, is people send me lots of manuscripts, they get in touch, they want me to publish their piece. And I have to make a decision, is this worthy of publication? Does the world need this piece, or does it not? Back in, I want to say early 2000s, this is around 2007, something like that, I was in Arkansas. I go to a lot of state music teacher shows. I go all over the place, different states. I was in Arkansas, met a young man who was fresh out of college named Randall Standridge. And Randall was very humble, but he told me he had a couple of pieces he'd like me to think about publishing. And one of them I thought was fabulous. It turned out he wrote it when he was 12. And this is not the piece we're gonna play now, but I was really impressed with this guy. He wrote another piece, it was pretty good, but I said, Randall, that one's not ready for prime time. Here's what you need to do. Came back the next year, and he had this fabulous piece called Pandora that we had originally turned down, but I've had this long relationship with Randall since those days when he was fresh out of college. He's in his upper 30s now. He's written a tremendous amount of music that's really enriched the band literature. This is one of Randall's. Randall has lots of different moods. He writes sometimes slow, gorgeous pieces. Sometimes he writes fast and edgy. Well, it's time for that fast and edgy piece right now. He calls it Aggressivo, as fast as I'll get out. It is fun. It's in a minor key, sounds edgy, and we've been having a great time with Randall's piece here. This is Aggressivo. So we're trying to give you as much variety in music as we can, lots of variety between those last two pieces, I'd say. I did a poll. We were playing five pieces. I did a poll with the band and to see which piece they liked the best. Aggressivo was one of their top two, and the next one was the other top two. And I think they like it because it's a really good challenge. This piece changes tempo a lot of times. It's very, very tricky in a lot of ways, but it's probably the hardest piece we're playing, but they really, really enjoyed it. And that was by show of hands. They told me they did. This is the only classical piece on the concert. It was originally a piece by Reinhold Glier wrote this thing called The Red Pony way back when. I don't even know what it was, but this was a piece that stayed from that. I think it maybe was an opera. I should know better before I talked about it. But anyway, the tune you're going to hear, this is a theme in variations. You're going to hear the tune after a few measures of woodwind introduction in the low brass. It goes like this. Bump, 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 bump. You might be familiar with that tune. Then we have all sorts of different variations in different tempos on that theme. So here we go. We'll do our best. This is Variations on Russian Sailor's Dance.
Last number, I would like to very much thank Mr.
Mark Reed for inviting me to do this this conducting job. As I said, I've had a fabulous time. I think the kids have had a great time. It's so fun to see the music progress and grow. It's so fun to see kids with this much focus over, like, we seem to have practiced about 50 hours yesterday. I think it was really more like six. But we practiced all morning for 3 hours. That's a lot of time for a middle school kid to sit still in a seat and do their job. But you guys have done an admirable job staying with me. It's been so, so fun. And again, kudos to you parents for raising great kids. Kudos to the band directors for teaching the kids correct rehearsal discipline and teaching them the kids how to focus and teaching the kids to love music. And I believe this day and this weekend has helped them to love music even more by having this great experience together with music. Oh, one more thing, one more thought I always talk about on clinics like this is when the kids get together to do athletics like football, what are we doing? We're butting heads, we're bashing each other and beating each other up, but here we got kids from all sorts of different schools. I haven't done a poll to see how many schools we have, but we got lots of New Mexico, lots of Colorado, all over the place, coming together and making fabulous music together. What a way to make friends across different school districts, across state lines. This has been a phenomenal thing for me to do. I'll remember this 20 years as a highlight, and hope you guys too do as well. And I've really enjoyed being with you kids. Thank you for everything. And here's our last number. It's called Pinnacle by Rob Grice.
Thank you.
Mr. Ryan Crabtree has established himself as one of the premier music educators teaching in our state today. As you can read in his bio, he's taught at Fruita Monument High School for almost a decade. I had the great pleasure at last year's Colorado Music Educators Association Conference of hearing his Fruita High School band perform, and they were fantastic. So students in this band have had a great time working with Mr. Crabtree. This is the Blue Band and Mr. Ryan Crabtree.
This is the Blue Honor Band, and I'm here from Alamosa, Colorado, and I play clarinet, and our first piece is going to be Fort Canterbury March by David R. Holsinger.
Hi, my name is Sarah Kraft. I play the oboe and I live in Durango, and this is One Night in Athens by David Bobrowitz.
very much. Like Dr. Reese said, my name is Ryan Crabtree, and I'm so thrilled to be here working with these fantastic kids today. We've just had the best time the last 2 days. I don't like to talk at concerts. You didn't come to see me, you didn't come to hear me, so that's why I have the kids introduce the tunes. And just to review, we had Ariel introduce our first tune, and she got the pleasure of introducing the tune because she lives the furthest away down in San Luis, right? Awesome. And then we had Sarah, who lives the closest to Fort Lewis, and you just live down the street, don't you? Close enough.
Hi, my name is Indica Mestes. I'm from Alamosa, Colorado, and I'm introducing this because I'm the oldest person in the band. And our next piece we'll be playing is High Watermark, the Third Day by Michael Sweeney.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I've just had an absolute blast working with these kiddos the last 2 days. It's very clear that music is alive and well in Colorado and New Mexico. These are just such fantastic children. I commend all of their directors and all of you parents for getting them to the music lessons, getting them to band, getting them home from band, getting them to Fort Lewis for Fort Lewis Honor Band. All of the things that all of you parents and directors do, thank you so much, because to be able to come in and work with such fantastic kids like this for 2 days is like being on vacation. It is absolutely wonderful, and I thank you kiddos for all of your hard work the last day. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you very much, and we'll move on to our last tune. Safe travels the rest of your day, and hope you enjoy the rest of the concert.
Hi, my name is Chandler Jeep. I play the tenor saxophone at Durango High School, and I'm actually the youngest in the Gold Band right now. And we are playing Snake Charmer by Randall Stanstridge.
Thank you. All right, you made it. You're halfway there. Next band is the Gold Band, conducted by Ms. Janet Isham. You can see the program. She had a very, very long and distinguished career teaching in New Mexico. Actually taught for 36 years in Kirtland, New Mexico. You know, you've done a really great job when after you retire, they name a building after you, which is what they did down there. So Ms. Isham is fantastic. Students have had a great time with her. Please welcome her to the stage,
Janet Isham and the Gold Band.
Going to deviate from the order in the program. The first song we're going to play is American River Songs. American River Songs is based on the traditional and composed music of earlier time when the rivers and waterways were the lifelines of a growing nation.
Thank you.
by Steve Reinecke. This was written for a high school in Evans High School in Georgia. And it was homecoming day, and this little girl's house became on fire, and she was lost, her mom and her dad. And so, being homecoming, the band decided that they needed to do something for her. So for the spring concert, they had Steve Reinecke write Heaven's Light because she liked the stars. This is the poem that went with the piece. Some people come into our lives and quickly go. Some people move our souls to dance. They awaken us to new understanding with the passing whisper of their wisdom. Some people make the sky more beautiful to gaze upon. They stay in our lives for a while, leave footprints on our hearts, and we are never, ever the same.
Thank you.
soloist. In the first song, American River Song, I had soloist Lainey Shorthair from Kirtland. I have Tristan Dye from Durango. On two. And then in Heaven's Light, I had Jade Dunham on clarinet from Farmington. I had Elizabeth Clyde on flute, clarinet, from Kirtland. Kayla Lines from Bayfield. Kiera Vermish from Aztec. Ashley Howe from Fruta. Claire James from Durango. Dennis Costello, Durango. Becky Allen, Alamosa. And so thank you very much. Our next song is a march called Happy Times. And we want you to think that you are sitting at a parade in New Orleans for Mardi Gras. I have thoroughly had a great time these last 2 days with these students. We came together yesterday at 1 o'clock and started rehearsing and then practiced till off and on till 9 o'clock last night and came back and worked on it this morning. And they are an amazing, amazing group of students. Let's give them a hand. It is so wonderful to see so many parents supporting the music arts because it, with the all of the new rules and laws and all of that kind of stuff that goes on, in the schools nowadays, they're trying to take away some of our arts and our music. And so I appreciate you as parents being supportive of the music programs, whether it be band, orchestra, choir, theater, what, you know, all of that stuff. I sure appreciate it. And again, thank you for allowing your children to have me as a conductor. Our last piece. Our last piece is called Critical Mass. Critical mass is a scientific term that refers to the smallest amount of fissile material needed to sustain a nuclear chain reaction. Thank you very much. The timpani soloist on that was Taylor Hensley from Bloomfield. Thank you again, and thank you for coming.
So last band, this is the Skyhawk Select Band. As you can tell, I am not David Holsinger. We had a little travel snafu on Thursday. David was coming in. He lives just outside of Chattanooga, Tennessee. And actually had gotten to the airport and learned that they had canceled his flight. He was supposed to travel through DFW on American Airlines, coming from a regional airport to a regional airport. Tried to reroute him, spent a couple hours trying to get him to Chicago and all sorts of other places and drive to Huntsville, and wasn't able to happen. The earliest he would have been able to get here would have been today. He would have missed the bulk of this. So I stepped in last minute and have been having a great time with the top group here with the Select Band. We've kind of come close in past years. I think that's one of the things, anytime you're traveling to a regional airport like Durango, even though it's weird because it's like gorgeous here, you know, you would think, but there was ice in Dallas. David was really, really bummed. He was excited to come out here. He loves this area of the country. It's kind of what he does. But he was gracious enough last evening to speak to all the students via Skype. So we actually pulled down, there's a screen here that you can't see that we pulled down. We're able to see and talk to him for an hour, kind of get his insight on what goes on with music, goes on with composition. And he wanted me to pass along his apologies to all of you, the parents and the band directors, that he wasn't able to be here. We'll try to get him out here in the future, because he was really bummed. So before we get going with the last group, I've got a bunch of thank yous to issue. An event like this doesn't just happen, although we've been doing it long enough that I think we kind of have figured out some of the kinks. We've got a great support staff in Joel Kirkpatrick, our administrative assistant, who is somewhere around, I'm sure. He may, actually probably is over in the recital hall with the kids, so hi, Joel, thanks for all you do. Our other administrator, Shauna Blaylock, who does our scheduling and does a lot of the PR and the interaction with the band directors also. She's backstage, so thank you, Shauna, as well as, yeah. Not only do they help out with this, but they help us out with everything, and the music department at Fort Lewis would not be able to function without their help. Also, the faculty, we've got a great group of faculty. A couple actually kind of helped sort through everybody. Dr. Mark Walters is somewhere around. I saw him. He helped with the helped out with the woodwind placement. Professor John O'Neill, who you'll actually meet in a second, he's actually going to fill in on percussion back there on the last piece that we're doing with percussion. Also, we got percussion instruments. We had four bands going in four different places all across campus, one here, one in Jones Hall, two in the Student Union. We got percussion equipment from Bayfield. So Derek Smith, I'd like to thank you. You're around somewhere. Evelyn Black from Escalante Middle School, and Catherine Reed from Durango High School. We got stuff from her too, so thanks to them. So the first piece is a very traditional march called Coat of Arms. This is Coat of Arms.
Thank you.
So I bet when you decided you were going to come to this concert, you didn't realize you were coming to a party, did you? No. Well, this is Mariah's birthday. Say hey. So this is her birthday party without the hats, without the balloons. You know, she brought cupcakes down for some people, and I took offense to the fact that I didn't get one, and they brought me a pastry from John Pierre, so I think I got the better end of the deal, so thank you guys. This is March of the Belgian Paratroopers. So before we play our last piece, which is by David Holsinger, who's supposed to be here, I'd like to say a little bit about not only these students, but the three other bands that you saw on stage. You know, I think, and this happens with every generation, kind of gets a bad rap of, you know, this generation is too plugged in, whatever, yada, yada, yada. I think that happens every time a generation comes of age, but Without failure, these kids are great. I talked to every single one of the clinicians, every single one of the band directors, and there were no issues with any kids, which is a testament to the job you as parents have done. So thank you so much. Absolutely. And this is not an easy 24-hour period. These students arrived on campus yesterday about 1 o'clock. Between yesterday at 1 o'clock and today at noon, rehearsed for about 9 hours. I know it was the case with this band, and I know it was the case with the other bands. The concentration and attention span was unbelievable. Even I, standing up here conducting, felt myself kind of weighing off a couple times, and these kids with their great attitudes and great energy pulled me back every single time. So thank you so much. Last but not least, I want to thank the directors who are taking time out of their weekend, their Friday and Saturday, to bring kids here to meet each other, to share music, and hopefully bring stuff back to their school and back to your programs that will help you guys out. So thank you so much. I know how hard you work because I'm married to one of you. So thank you. And it can be somewhat of a thankless job sometimes, I know that. We all know that, so thank you so much. This is David Holsinger's Solemn Hymn and Rowdy Dance.